Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Bet you're wondering why you're staring at a big cardboard box. But there's a good reason for that. This is an auction item that I won at the Fiero 40th. So we're going to open it up live right here and unbox it and show you what we got. And it's going to be really interesting to all you Fiero fans out there with fastbacks. So let's get started and we'll just crack this puppy right open. All right, guys, we're just going to open this thing up. They did a pretty good job of taping it up. These are from the Fiero store. And I've been wanting to take a look at these for the longest time. Never got a chance because didn't really need them. And when it came up for sale at the auction, I said to myself, you know what, this is a perfect opportunity to pick up a set and take a look at them. So, you guys are going to love this. And here we are. These are the Fiero Store Premium Quarter Windows. Now, these are the ones that they sell to replace our old, cracked quarter windows. And these are the premium version. So, let me give you guys a good look at that. You can see the glass here. Let's see. Oh, let me give you guys a really good look at that. Let me get you right in the camera there. You can see the glass. It looks really, really nice. I have to admit. Here's the back. Here you can see it's got the GT badging on the glass. It's got the dot matrix pattern, which we are all familiar with. Let's see if you guys can get a good look at that. And it seems to be following the curvature of the car and of the original. As many of the aftermarket models of these glass, and even the Fiero store's own lower priced version of the glass, don't maintain this curvature along the side of the car here. And that's an easy giveaway that the glass is aftermarket, as most of them are flat. As getting a compound curve like this is not the easiest thing to do, because you're not only are you curving the glass this way, you're curving the edge of the glass this way. So these are their top of the line replacement quarter windows, and they look beautiful. And so now maybe you guys are saying to yourself, yeah, but are they really the same as the factory ones? Well, if any of you guys are eagle-eyed back there and can see what's behind this box, I have two brand new, never used, new old stock quarter windows. They've never been installed on a car. And we're going to compare the Fiero store's quarter windows to these brand new ones, and we'll see exactly how they stack up. Now, one difference I can already tell is that there's a little bit more of a green tint to the Fiero store windows. Now, is that a little darker than the factory windows? We're going to find out. Let's get the other window out and take a look at that one. Okay. I'm going to unwrap this one here. And what do we have here? Oh. Here we have an instruction sheet that comes with them for quarter window removal. We're going to walk you through the removing of the quarter window. And installing of the new one. Even has pictures in it. So this is almost like for my scale model, guys. This is your instruction sheet. Huh. That's kind of cool. Alright, so let's put the instruction sheet to the side. And let's unwrap this one. And take a look at it. this one is looking really just as good as the last one. Let's check all our curves.
Yeah, it's got the
vertical curve that goes follows the body line, and it's got the end curve where it curves into the car here. Wow, these things really are very nice. But how do they stack up against the originals? That's what we're going to find out right now. Because if I move this box over, you guys can see the original quarter windows right next to these. Now, let me just give you guys a little better look. Let's zoom in a little bit here. Now, right off the bat, you can see that the green tinting is a little bit darker on the Fiero store windows, as even the GT emblem is showing the silver with a greenish tint. So that is one difference we have between the original factory ones and the Fiero store ones. Now, let's take a look and compare the curve of the original factory to the Fiero store one. What we have here is our factory, and here is our Fiero store quarter glass. And as you can see, they match up almost exactly as far as the curvature goes when you put the two of them together. And now the edge, the upper edge here, the Fiero store one does have a sharper upper edge than the factory GM ones. And the Fiero store ones seem to be, I don't know if they're a little bit thicker or not. But thicker would probably work in our favor. Now, let's just take a look at the shapes of the glass themselves. And the Fiero store glass seems to mimic the shape of the original perfectly, even down to the cutout at the bottom of the glass. So let's, excuse my hand, I'm going to bring you guys in here to get a good look at these. You can see the shape of the Fiero store glass. And the GM factory glass. Now, remember, these are new old stock GM quarter windows. They've never been used, never been installed in a car. So what I'm going to do is we're going to lay this right on top here, and we'll see how well the dot matrix patterns line up, as this is something that nobody will ever measure, but just so that we can see. And as you can see, it's an exact fit over the original GM quarter glass. You can see it matches the curve of the end exactly to the original GM quarter glass. And I can't really test this one, as this one still has its wrapping installed, and I don't want to pull that off. That just kind of peels off the glass, but I don't really want to remove that, as I want to keep them protected, because those are going to be replacements for my car. And these will be replacements for the replacements, unless I get another fastback that needs quarter glass. But overall, I would say I have to give a thumbs up to the Fiero store for reproducing these quarter windows. Because if the only difference in the quarter window is going to be the green tint of the glass, I would say it's something that we can live with. Because they've done what, from my experience, mind you, unless there's a quarter glass out there I haven't seen, they've done what no one else has been able to do, which is to get the curvature of the glass correct so that it doesn't sit flat on the body. It actually curves with the shape of the body. So if I needed quarter windows, and as we all know, as fastback owners, that they are made of unobtainium at this point, because finding original factory ones is a unicorn. Now, I found my unicorn, but finding another set, probably next to impossible. So this is a great alternative. I've got to give the Fiero store thumbs up on this. And other than the slight green tint, these things are an excellent, excellent alternative to having the original glass. And at this point, you know, a lot of us need to replace that original glass. So there you go, guys. I recommend this product 100% because it does seem to mimic the original glass just about perfectly. As for installation, you can use the 3M double-sided tape, as GM originally did. Or, if it were up to me, I would use urethane for mounting the windshield. It's more of a permanent bond, and if you ever have to replace it again, it will be a pain to get off. But it'll hold on and it'll never let go. I've worked with it quite a bit, and installing windshields and removing windshields, and the urethane does work very well, specifically for this type of purpose. All right, guys, that's going to be it for this comparison. The question has now been answered, whether these Fiero store replacement quarter windows are worth the money. I say yes, 100%. And I give them a 9.5 out of 10. And I'm only taking away that half point because of the green tint to the glass, which is something that I can live with, because really, what other choice do you have? And when the replacements are this good, one tiny little detraction is nothing to keep you from getting them. So I recommend them 100%. All right, guys, that's going to be it. We got a lot more stuff coming, so stay tuned.